Red Kia. His shot knocked down by Hutchison. Out to Darryl Sittler.
Oh, the glove went flying in the air, and they're all into it. Boy, the electricity is really something in here now. There's the jersey off. Roosehead on the perimeter, taking a look at things as punches are flying in all directions here at the Omni in Atlanta. Sittler lands a good right. Sticks all over the ice. Everybody standing here at the Omni. Shand and Tiger Williams now in front of a Leaf bench.
Well, they're throwing now.
Throwing.
Good left. Well, anytime you get a lot of body check being thrown out there, Brian, it's, sooner or later, you're going to have a fight or two, and it's exactly what happened. I don't know how the Atlanta Flames have that extra man on the ice, but they do.
This crowd has been in an uproar since Cronoval got the first Atlanta goal. Make it a 2-1 game. Now Hutchison wants to get in. Little Bobby Lalonde gets in there. Six of the Flames. Houston is involved. Hutchison still throwing punches. They can't bring him down. There are two or three of them. Palmateer is furious, banging his stick on the ice. Now the Leafs come off. Turnbull comes out to help, and he starts punching. We could have something.
Well, see,
out of hand here.
The Atlanta Flames had the extra man on the ice. I don't know where he came from, but Turnbull jumped on the
ice. Well, you weren't the only one to spot that. Palmateer was really getting frustrated. You could sense that he wanted to get involved. He was banging his goal stick on the ice. He noticed the discrepancy in numbers. Turnbull finally came off the bench and got into it. Turnbull has his opponent pinned now right on the blue line as Shand and Williams are still ready for another round. Randy Mitten, now this is some game for his first playoff game. Randy Mitten from Calgary.
You know, Houston and Rota were both taking shots at Hutchison, and then that's when Turnbull jumped on the ice. Have a few ejections after this, Brian.
A lot of underwear showing out there on the Flames part. Finally got Williams divorced from Shand. Now Houston has challenged Williams, and here comes Plett. He'd like a piece of Williams. So the Leafs move in, and they square off once again. You'd think they'd be too tired to carry on anymore. The captain says, I'm going to get a drink here.
I'm just wondering, Gary, with 51 seconds remaining, whether the referee might play it in the next period.
Oh, Burrows is into it now. Look at those punches.
You have no idea how that takes takes the strength out of you for the rest, the remainder of the game. You know, you're just whipped, so you can appreciate how well-conditioned those boxers are.
Well, that was Shand and Burrows. Shand had quite a wrestling match and a punch-up with Williams, and he must have a lot of energy because he decided to throw some punches then with Burrows. Just 51 seconds, as you mentioned, Gary, to play in this second period. tired. Now it's up to Bruce Hood to sort out the penalty minutes and find out what happened to Turnbull.
You know, it might be a good idea right now just to send both teams to the dressing room and add on the 51 seconds to the next period. You know, get...
Well, I agree with that. That might be a good idea. And wonder why they don't hurt themselves more in these fights. There aren't more broken bones in the hand. Look at Tiger.
Now here we go.
Cliff Fletcher told me before the game, if the Leafs want to get physical, we'll stand right up to them. He said, not concerned about us being intimidated.
Well, I think, you know, intimidation has played such a big part in professional hockey. But I think once you get in the National Hockey League, it's very difficult to intimidate the majority of the players, you know, or you wouldn't be in here. It's a tough league, so you're not going to run anybody out of the ice, out of the building. I think some players are just a little more aggressive than others. Well, they locked Tiger outside the ice surface.
Not for long. There's the time remaining, 51 seconds, and as Gary's mentioned, there's a possibility we may play it in the next period, and that's exactly what's going to happen. The teams are going to leave the ice.
Yeah, by the time they get everything sorted out, and you know, it could erupt again, so send the teams to the dressing room, get everybody a chance to gain their composure and think what they have to do in that next period.